Welcome grade 9 back to our online classes. I would like to continue with our editing and omission. I have already covered subject verb agreement with you because that is a very important part in our editing omission. And now I would like to cover one more very important topic, that is tenses. Now tenses and subject verb agreement, these two are going to be very, very important in the sense that they give you command over your writing skills and your grammatical mistakes. You will make less grammar errors when you are thorough with tense, right? So we have already done tenses before. This is going to be a short recap. So please follow the lecture, and then if we have doubts, we can always connect with each other, right? So on with the lecture, right? Thank you. So children, welcome back to our online classes. We are going to continue with editing omission. And in this editing omission, we have decided to revise sentence verb. We have decided to revise the various parts of speech. We have decided to revise our tenses also. So I will now take you to tenses, because tenses is one of the most important section that you need to cover thoroughly, and it will help you to get a strong command over the language and obviously your writing skill. Now, you have already done your tenses in your last classes, but then this is going to be a review, not a detailed one, but a refresher that will help you to catch up with whatever we have learned, right? So we move on. What is tense actually expressing? The tenses are actually expressing the time of an event or action, right? Verb tenses always express the time of an event or action, and its expression is very important to all English language readers. In this lesson, we are going to review the meaning of each verb tense, right? I am going to cover past and present only in this lecture, and in the future lecture, I'll be completing the future tense. Right, so we move on. Simple present tense. It expresses a habit or often repeated action. So you must be understanding that what is a habit actually? A habit means a regular course of action or any repeated action. Supposing I am doing something over and over again, so it becomes a habit or a repeated action. So these kind of actions are normally expressed in present tense. Also remember that adverbs of frequency like often, seldom, sometimes, never, always, etc. are also used with this tense. Now she goes to work every day. This is a habit. She goes to work every day. They always eat together. This is a part of the habit. So it is expressed in simple present tense. Now, this tense also expresses general truths or facts that are timeless. Means the natural truths or facts that can never change, that are changeless. They are also expressed in simple present tense. Like water boils at 100 degrees centigrade, sun rises in the east. They are natural truths or phenomena. So they will never change, and they will be expressed in simple present tense. The present progressive or the present continuous tense, this is used to describe an action that is continuing right now. Right now means at this moment, today, etc. That action has begun and is still in progress. That is why it is known as the present progressive. Like she is typing a paper for her class. She is typing. She had started typing a paper and then she is still typing her paper. I am teaching my students. I have started teaching my students sometime before and I'm still teaching my students. You are watching the video now. You have started watching the video sometime before and you are still watching now. The action has not ended. And so this becomes examples of present progressive. The present progressive is also used to describe an action that is occurring in the present but is temporary. Now, when we are thinking of some action that is occurring at the moment, but is temporary, it is not going to continue, it is short-lived. In that case, we also call it a present progressive tense. Like he is living there, but he might move soon. So in this case, he is living there. Yes, it is present. The present situation is he is living there, but he might move soon, but he might move out soon. So like this, the simple past, we use the simple past to indicate exactly when an event or an action took place in the past and no longer true in the present. That action is already over. That action is not continuing into the present, and that is why it is over and is known as past tense. I visited my sister yesterday. We went out to dinner last night. So you can see these actions are already over, yesterday and last night. And so they are used as simple past. Now the past progressive is also used to describe an activity that was in progress at a particular time in the past. The past progressive is also like present progressive, but that is not continuing now. That action was continuing in the past at a particular point of time. Like in present progressive, you have the action still continuing. But in past progressive, the action continued at a particular point of time. I was reading a book when the doorbell rang. When the doorbell rang, that particular point of time, I was reading a book. They were eating dinner when the neighbors stopped by for a visit. When the neighbors came for a visit, that time they were eating dinner. Means that action was on at that particular point of time. And in present progressive, that action is still on. In past progressive, that action was on. Right? So we move on to present perfect. The present perfect is used to describe an action that began in the past and continues to the present. Now we have seen what is present tense. We have seen what is present progressive or present continuous tense. We have seen what is past tense, and we have also seen what is past continuous tense. Now we are moving on to present perfect tense. The present perfect tense is used to describe an action that began in the past and continues to the present moment. It had begun in the past and it continues to the present moment. It is also used to describe an action that was completed in the past, but the specific time of the event is not important. Like, he has lived here for 2 years. This action, living here, had begun in the past. It has begun. It is already there. The person has been living here. So, in present perfect tense, the action is still on, but the action had begun in the past. He has lived here. He had started living here from some time. And he is living here for 2 years. So he has lived here. If I would like to express this tense, this sentence in present perfect tense, I will say he has lived here, has lived. Becomes the part of present perfect. Has lived becomes the part of present perfect. For 2 years means he is still living. He has not discontinued. He is still living and he has lived here for 2 years. I have seen that movie before. See, I have seen that movie. Right, that action is already over. But that event, the time of that event is not important. The time of the event is not important. That was seen just few or some time back. If it is seen long time back, then you can think of some other tense we will describe or we will come to later. But if the action is recently completed, then we have to use present perfect tense. I have seen that movie before last week. That means last week is not important. The only part that is important is I have seen. Have seen becomes a part of present perfect. He has already visited Vietnam. It is not important when. He has visited Vietnam some time before. So it becomes a part of present perfect. He has visited becomes a part of present perfect. Now what is present perfect progressive or present perfect continuous? This tense is used to describe the duration of an action that began in the past and continues into the present. That action began in the past and it continues into the present. So present perfect does not need any specific time or duration, but present perfect progressive needs the specific time or duration because it is still continuing into the present. Why and how? He has been studying grammar for 1 hour. So it is expressed like he has been studying. He had started studying long time back, an hour before. So this is expressed as he has been studying. He is still studying. Okay, for 1 hour. She has been cooking the whole day. She has started cooking sometime before and she is still cooking the whole day. So he is still studying and she is still cooking. So it becomes present perfect progressive. And how do you identify? What are the indicators? Has plus been plus verb plus ings. So he has been studying. Study is the verb. Ing is the added. She has been cooking. Has been cook is the verb. Ing is added. Now we also need to add the duration to present perfect progressive. So for 1 hour, he has been studying. The whole day, she has been cooking. So like this, present perfect progressive is described or stated. Now we move on to the next part. This tense is also used to describe events that have been in progress recently, but rather temporary. Like she has been living in Taiwan for the last 2 months, but she plans to move soon. So you can very well see this is present perfect progressive. Till last 2 months, we always know duration has to be there, but she plans to move soon. So it is going to end shortly. This action is going to end shortly, but still we can use it as or under present perfect progressive tense. Temporary actions that have started before and is about to end soon can also be described under present perfect progressive. Now we come to the past perfect. This tense is describing completed events that took place in the past before another past event. Mind it very carefully. There are two situations where we have one event completing before the other. Like the Titanic had received. You can see one event here. The Titanic had received many warnings. So you can see one event in the past occurring here. Before it hit the iceberg. So there are two actions, two events taking place. Before it hit the iceberg is the second event. So one event, when it occurs before the second event, then we use past perfect tense. I had already eaten. I had already eaten means my food was over. My dinner, my lunch, whatever it was over when my friend stopped by to visit. So there are two actions. One is eating food that was already over. And the second action is the friend stopping by for a visit. So when an action happens before another action, we put it under the past perfect tense. Now the past perfect progressive tense, this tense is used to emphasize द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ एन एक्शन दैट वॉज कंप्लीटेड बिफोर अनदर एक्शन और इवेंट इन द पास्ट. नाउ हियर इट इज सिमिलर टू पास्ट परफेक्ट. ओनली वी नीड टू एड द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ द एक्शन. लाइक इन प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट प्रोग्रेसिव वी हैड एडेड द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ द एक्शन. Similarly, here also in past perfect progressive, we also need to add the duration of the action. She had been driving one action for 3 hours. You can see the duration is very clearly stated before she finally found the right office. So you can very well see before she finally found the right office. The action, two actions. She had been driving in the city and then we put the duration before she finally found the right office. The second action, right? I believe that is all for now and we will move on to our next. And so that was the lecture all about for now. You have understood present tense and you have also understood past tense in their various forms. And now we will continue with our assignment. And in the next lecture, I will try to elaborate future tense also like this. So we will be done with tenses and we will be only left with revisions and practice. Right, children? Love you all.